Hi everyone, my name is Sergio Rossi, RF Application Engineer at ST Microelectronics. Today I'd like to introduce our S2LP device. The S2LP is our high-performance, ultra-low-power sub-1 GHz radio transceiver. More information can be found on www.st.com. Searching for S2LP in the search engine, you will be direct to the product webpage, where you can find all the relevant information, including the device datasheet, the technical documentation, the full list of software and hardware tools. S2LP supports operation in the Sigfox networks. The first mandatory step to enable Sigfox operation is to register the device on both ST side Sigfox backend. In our previous video, we showed the ST side registration procedure, obtaining the node ID and PAC. This video will guide you through the step-by-step procedure for registering the node on the Sigfox backend using the ST-Eval FKI 950 V1 evaluation board and STM32 Nucleo development board. Now, let's start registering the device on the Sigfox backend. Before to start, be sure that your ST-Eval kit is connected to your PC with the ST GUI up and running. Go to this link, backend.sigfox.com/activate/STM for kit registration. Check for the country where the board will be operate. Scroll down, US in this case. Click on this tab. Insert the device information, basically ID and PAC number. Quickly, you can copy and paste this number from the GUI. Click on Next button. Fill in this form to obtain an account on the Sigfox backend. If you have already an account, sign in to add this new node. Otherwise, first name, last name, email address, choose the time zone, and company name. Click on the subscribe button. The activation kit procedure is done. An email will be sent to the specified email address. Open your email account and check an email from Sigfox. Open. Click on the link to choose a password for your new Sigfox account. Click OK button. A pop-up with terms and conditions of use of the Sigfox portal will show up. Read carefully and click on the Accept button to proceed. This is the Sigfox backend portal. Go to the device section. This section provides a list of registered devices. Click on the device ID to access another summary page information. Click on Messages on the left to show a list of all sent messages. No messages in this case because it's the first use. To check the coverage and the functionality of the node, go back to our ST graphical user interface. Click on the TX button to transmit data. In accordance with the Sigfox protocol, the frame is repeated 3 times with a 500 millisecond interval. The duration of each frame is shown in the frame duration box. The maximum length of a message is 12 bytes. The message should be received by the Sigfox base stations and shown in the device messages section of the Sigfox backend. Let's go now to check. As you can see, the message is present under your device. For each message, the following base information is shown: date and time, data received, location of the node, link to a map, and link quality indicator, SNR, signal to noise ratio. For additional information on the Sigfox backend portal, we suggest also to check the YouTube channel from Sigfox. Now your S2LP node is ready to communicate over the Sigfox network. I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial and thanks for watching. Bye!